your intellectual savior of Money in the Bank, Damian Sandow.
Oh, hold up! Cody Rhodes! Cody Rhodes! Sandow's former buddy.
Cody Rhodes, who obviously now we can see felt like he got screwed last night.
That's just bad sportsmanship.
What? Bad sportsmanship. But what Damian Sandow did last night was good sportsmanship.
It was legal.
And Sandow retreating through the WWE fans. Cody Rhodes bought into it. He bought into the fact that him and Sandow were best buddies.
He is still Mr. Money in the Bank, and he is still the next World Heavyweight Champion. You better get used to that and get used to saying that name, Damian Sandow.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God. Uh-oh.
Becky.
Reversal. Oh! Spatters fly from the champion.
My gosh. What a counter.
Can we see it again? KOD.
With authority.
One, two, three. The champion retains.
Here's your winner. And still the Raw Women's Champion, Bianca.
What a battle, what an ovation. Nissan Stadium is rocking.
Becky Lynch is a woman without purpose. The unraveling continues.
A good sportsmanship displayed by Becky Lynch in defeat.
More than a match, Bianca Belair has earned the respect of Becky Lynch.
And that's huge. That is huge for the ESD.
How do you get out of this thing?
That's big in the hands. The Undertaker brought the arm. The Undertaker broke the hold.
That, I don't know how, but he did.
Undertaker broke the vice grip. No! And the great Khali and delivers some offense of his own.
Some way, somehow, the dead man took the grip. Oh,
wait a minute. A Big Show. Big Show into the ring. Referee called for the bell. And the Big Show. Whoa! Oh! After the Undertaker's had a deal with a great Khali, the Big Show takes a cheap shot.
There's no way that the Undertaker was 100%.
Oh, no, no. The Big Show with a weapon. That, you see that steel chair in the hands of the world's largest athlete. Oh, yeah, they did.
The Big Show left the great Khali to do his dirty work.
Thank you. No. Energy. Are you ready for the most electrifying man in sports and entertainment?
Bliss's aid. Kyrie Sane not going to allow it to happen.
Easy to face takedown cross. More tandem offense.
Double team.
In on new champs.
Meanwhile, Alexa Bliss in trouble. Asuka looking to lock it in again. She got Mandy to tap earlier on. Nowhere to go. Bliss, though, rolls through. Asuka's shoulders are down. Almost had her. Asuka almost got caught by Alexa Bliss. Now Bliss runs right into a knee. Alexa may be out cold.
There goes the championship dreams of Cross and Bliss.
Tag made. Kyrie's legal.
The Bookie Warriors.
Heading up to the top rope, maybe looking for the insane elbow. Her finishing maneuver. Nikki Cross on the apron. Nikki, referee never saw it. Chucked Zayn off the top rope. Asuka caught up in the apron.
Nikki Cross is pummeling Asuka. Drop kick from the goddess.
Relentless.
Oh, and Nikki dropped off the apron. Bliss with a right hand. Kyrie is out.
It could be moments away.
Twisted Bliss connecting.
But for being iconic, the downright celestial, guys.
Rhea Ripley making her presence known in a big way here at Full Sail Live as she confronts Shayna Baszler and the Horsewomen. What a shock!
Presence is an understatement. She commands it and demands it.
I know what you're gonna say. You're gonna say that you've beaten everyone here, but you haven't beaten me.
Whoa!
Wow! Rhea Ripley looking to write her story at the expense of the Horsewomen. She is the epitome of badass in the NXT Women's Division.
Wants to snatch the NXT Women's title from around the waist of Baszler, just like she just snatched the microphone out of Baszler's hand.
The Horsewomen have been running things here a long time, and things have just changed. Challenge made.
I tell you what, folks, we've seen a lot of Super Bowls. The game doesn't live up to the hype. In my opinion, this match lived up to the hype.
It didn't live up to it, it far surpassed it. It was great.
On this night, at this magnificent event, the young lion, The Rock, has pulled it out over the veteran lion.
Look at this, JR. Look at this face off. Look at this square off again. Hulk Hogan's on his feet. He's still staring into the eyes of The Rock.
Like him or not, Hogan is a proud man.
Are they going to go again?
Oh,
disgusting. I hate to say that for what we've seen, but it's just a fact. And I'll be damned, King. King, I'll be damned, King. I'll be damned.
Boy, when's the last time you saw a class act like that, JR?
I don't remember that. A handshake, and that's something you rarely see. And a handshake that will be remembered for many, many years to come. And Hogan, quite honestly, giving The Rock his props. And Hogan had to know. He had to know if he could do it one-on-one. A great effort, like the son of a gun or not. A great effort by the veteran.
All the emotion in Toronto this weekend. Not kissing up to anybody, but it's going to be there.
Oh, wait a minute.
With Trish's last match.
If at first you don't succeed, try again.
And that has been Trish's whole attitude. She's dogmatic. She never gives up. She's has a great will to win and has always improved. A six-time women's champion. Look at Trish not backing up a bit, shooting those forearms right into the face of Mickey James.
Oh, boy. Look at this move.
Oh, look at this.
Whoa!
Wow. A little Mickey go-around action there. Trish using her leg strength again.
Gonna miss Trish on Raw. Oh, went for the chick kick.
And Mickey the roll-on and got the... No, she did get the three.
Two, two.
And Mickey complaining a little. What the hell is Lita doing to
Lita?
Lita slithering down and got on the apron. The women's champion. And,
oh,
and Trish hits satisfaction in spite of Lita being on the apron.
Well, instead of the ring rope, she used Trish, Lita's face. And a win.
Here's your winner, Trish Stratus.
So, King, no matter what happens this Sunday at Unforgiven in Trish's hometown of Toronto, on pay-per-view, Trish is going to leave Monday Night Raw with a victory. How deserving.
Wow.
She's so young, so beautiful. It may be premature for me to say this, but I wouldn't be surprised to see that young lady in the WWE Hall of Fame someday. Right alongside the fabulous Moolah and Jerry Martel.
That's the class. I like it.
Mickey knows that how much Trish has meant to the WWE.
Oh, how much Trish has meant to Mickey.
Here I am. And as much as it hurts me to have to admit this, last night, Hulk Hogan was the better man. But you had to be there to appreciate it. It was amazing. It was incredible. He was cat-like. He was agile. He was nimble. He had a catcher's catch can style that even yours truly, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, quite honestly, couldn't figure out. I mean, his ring prowess was in so many ways and on so many levels superior to mine that I simply could not compete. And when it was over, even I, the evil Shawn Michaels, found myself falling victim, like so many before me, to the vicious leg drop. One, two, three.
There ain't no going back now. We've gone too far. You're ours, and we're yours. Look at this guy. He don't care about you. He's dragged you down since day one. He's a care about you. I love you. I give you everything. This ring is yours when you're with the club. Otherwise, go and do.
Stand there with all the gold you want, but none of you will ever be an Olympic gold medalist.
He's absolutely right.
You want to talk about home of the gold? Well, this is my gold. And this is Pittsburgh, PA.
Father's Playbook ace, Cowboy Bob Orton, who was known for the superplex, but Dean Ambrose trying to turn the tables, delivering some short elbows.
Don't forget, Randy's been working on Dean's lower back all match.
Kick to the midsection, looking for Dirty Deeds, turned around.
Looking for the RKO, Dean countered.
Lunatic lariat by the Intercontinental Champion, back cover by Ambrose and Orton, able to lift that left shoulder in the nick of time.
I think it's the only cover that Ambrose was able to get at the time.
Hotly contested matchup, much to the chagrin of the Wyatt family on the outside.
Well, look, I think it's to be expected. Look, this Intercontinental Champion, Dean Ambrose. I think they knew that Randy was going to be in one heck of a fight. And Randy is.
Two of the biggest superstars on SmackDown Live going mano a mano. Ambrose with a full head of steam, forearm.
Uh-oh. See, right now, this is not where Dean Ambrose wants to be.
Oh, well scouted by Ambrose. As Orton was looking for the draping DDT, instead he's deposited to the outside and helped to his feet now by Luke Harper. Here comes Ambrose, come back, Cena wipes out Harper.
Harper and Ambrose go crash into our desk.
Oh, Orton catching Ambrose, draping DDT.
Wasted time,
and just
now.
Like that, the momentum back on the side of Randy Orton.
That's what happens when you divert your attention away from the 12-time world champion, Randy Orton.
It's hard not to. You have these Wyatts outside.
Get ready. Randy hears voices.
Intercontinental Champion with a hard-fought victory over Randy Orton.
Well, look, Luke Harper is obviously upset because Dean Ambrose had taken him out. Luke Harper goes back in for a little retribution. Bray Wyatt stops that interference, and Randy Orton diverts his attention from Dean Ambrose and gets beat.
Yeah, but John Harper of it also stopped Randy Orton's momentum.
And Bayley, here she comes.
Tighten the topknot.
You know what's coming when she tightens up the hair tie. From the second rope, big elbow.
Come on, Bayley, get
championship
that cover
on the line.
Could
Bayley
be it.
Catching, grabbing. Charlotte able to kick out.
Charlotte realizes how close she was. Look at the face right there.
Bayley can feel it. She can smell the NXT Women's Championship. But look out. What a neck breaker by Charlotte. And hold on. That's it, what a fight by Bayley, but Charlotte with a big victory.
Here's your winner and still NXT Women's Champion, Charlotte.
So Jason, is Bayley gonna cry again? Is she gonna whine here at NXT how she needs another opportunity at this championship, undeserved?
Bayley left it all out there, I'm proud of her. I think Bayley needs to go see a trainer and get that knee checked out. The amount of pressure that Charlotte put on that knee throughout the match, and she kept coming and coming and coming.
All that's great, but who's still got the title? That beautiful woman right there.
That's all.
All that matters.
She's as good as she says she is.
What a way to start things off tonight here on NXT. Display of sportsmanship.
That's respect right there.
Respect deserved, respect earned. Charlotte retains the NXT Women's Championship.
Mr. Fuji spat on Lex Luger as if he was spitting on America. And with that, Mr. Fuji went for the ride he'll never forget. And Lex Luger began to prepare. Prepare, yes, for the slam. Prepare for the attempt. And the look of intensity in his eye told the whole story. And then from there it happened, the 550-pounder charge. Luger ducking out of the way, nailing Yokozuna with a 6-inch steel plate in the forearm. And from there, yes, yes, it was unbelievable. Lex Luger had done it. Lex Luger had accomplished the impossible. He slammed the 550-pound WWF champion down to the mat. Down to the deck of the USS Intrepid. And yes, this was what it's all about. America and Lex Luger would not be denied the celebration of her birthday. Thousands of fans on board the USS Intrepid saluting the great country we live in and saluting one of the great competitors who stepped forward to be counted on July 4th, Sunday, America's birthday.
How could you do this to me, Stephanie? How could you do this to me after everything we've been through? I gave you everything I had, night in and night out. I put this company, your company, on my back, and I blew every ligament in my knee for it. And I came back faster than anyone could have imagined for you, and this is how you repay me.
Oh, that's a great story, Seth. But you're wrong. This is absolutely about me. This is the Kevin Owens show, haven't you heard?
Kevin, I've got no problem with you right now. I understand you are just a puppet. But if you don't shut the hell up, not even Triple H is gonna be able to save you tonight. You got me?
Seth, I had absolutely no idea that Hunter was trying to come down
bull
here.
Crap.
I didn't know.
Bullcrap. You expect me to believe that?
She said she had nothing
you
to do with it.
Me
she
to
had nothing
that?
To do with it.
Oh, really? Well, what did you have to do with it? Are you in her pocket too, huh?
No, he's not in my pocket.
Are you in her
no
pocket
one's in
too?
My pocket.
Everybody's in your pocket, and everybody knows it.
I'm not in her pocket, but I sure as hell have her back.
Kevin Owens, he's been Triple H's chosen one from day one. From the moment he stepped foot in NXT, he's had his hand held the entire way. But if you want to hitch your wagons to this guy here, make him the face of the new era, then mark my words. I will be the one to burn it to the ground. And you and your husband, the king and queen, you're gonna be on your knees begging and pleading in a pile of rubble. You got me?
I can smell my cheese.
But your remarks, I was like,
no, right, McMahon? Like, you had nothing to do with this.
But I'll tell you what, we're not totally heartless, Razor Ramon. We think we can give him a job, right, Irwin? We can find some domestic work for you to do. Maybe like cleaning our toilets, polishing our shoes.
Shining our cars up, nice wax job.
I think that's very good.
Mr. Ramon, why are you here?
Okay, rich man, tax man, let me get it right. The bad guy, trabajo para ustedes. I work for you.
I think he's asking for a job.
No way. I've done a lot of work with my hands, man. Only Chico, I do it for me. I don't work for you. And I don't work for you.
I like it.
Well, Mr. DiBiase, what about it, huh?
So basically what you're telling me is you don't have a price? Take a long, hard look, machismo. This is mean green. And like I've always said, everybody's got a price. Even you.
Uh-oh.
And The Undertaker, with a tilt slam up the top of the ladder, has won one hell of a fight! One hell of a fight! But it was not to be on this fateful night, on this ladder match.
Wait a minute, hey, Undertaker. That pump's getting up.
Jeff Hardy is getting back up.
You better stay down, kid.
This kid is gonna, he will not die. Jeff Hardy will not die. He will not stay down.
Don't speak too soon. Lay down!
Leave him alone!
Lay down, boy!
Enough is enough!
You should have just laid down.
There's no reason for this!
Well, there is a reason!
Damn last ride!
No.
All I know is that Jeff Hardy made his family, he made the WWE proud!
Wait a minute.
Hey!
Oh, tell me, he's not talking.
You haven't broke me, Taker! You haven't broke me! I'm still standing.
Oh, God. No, you're not. Cut the mic
off. From the ropes, I'm standing.
Cut the damn mic off. That's enough. This kid, Jeff, don't do it.
Right, that's enough,
Jeff. That's enough.
Throw the mic.
You got nothing to prove, kid.
Give us that microphone.
You got nothing to prove. And Jeff Hardy's defenseless here. There's no reason for this. Can't even defend himself. I shudder to think what the Undertaker's gonna do to this kid who gave us his heart, his soul. He's helpless.
Look.
He's helpless. As I said, he's defenseless. And then there he is, the Undertaker, raising Jeff Hardy's hand. What the hell is up with that?
So Braun Strowman can walk around all that he wants and bill himself as a monster. My client, Brock Lesnar, doesn't bill himself as a beast. He's not a man, he is a beast. And Braun Strowman, you're not in Brock Lesnar's league. You're not in Brock Lesnar's category. You're not in Brock Lesnar's stratosphere. Braun Strowman, you can't compare to Brock Lesnar's. You're not even a member of the same species as Brock Lesnar.
Uh-oh. Run, Paul, run. Braun Strowman's about ready to feast on the Beast's advocate.
The only words that need to be come out of your mouth right now are to tell Brock Lesnar that I'm gonna beat his ass all over Ground Jewel. And when I beat his ass, I'm bringing the Universal Championship back to Monday Night Raw. And not just when I want to, I'm bringing it every single Monday. And I know I've had my differences with him over the past few years, but when Roman Reigns beats leukemia, he'll be first in line in a title opportunity. But for right now, Brock Lesnar is gonna get these hands.
She's coming out here. Is she nuts? The man has arrived. There's seven members of the Monday Night Raw roster in the ring, and Becky Lynch is marching down to the ring.
The man shows no fear.
Well, yeah, Becky, I mean, you want to be the man. Wait a minute, who the hell, what the heck? Holy, that SmackDown's here! SmackDown's here! SmackDown Women's Division! is attacking Monday Night Raw.
Sonya Deville, Carmella, Asuka, Becky Lynch, Naomi.
The Raw Women's
Charlotte comes the Queen.
Alexa Bliss ran away. Meanwhile, the Raw team is getting beaten up by the SmackDown
numbers game.
What a wild sight it is seeing Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch fight alongside one another.
And then as Becky Lynch made her way into the arena, the SmackDown women attack the Raw women. And here comes Ronda Rousey.
With one good arm, and Becky Lynch retreats.
Becky Lynch making her way out of the ring as Ronda Rousey now goes to work.
Oh, Ronda Rousey's hurt. Her arm is damaged.
See Ronda instinctively trying to use the left.
Becky Lynch!
Becky's got a chair.
Lynch with a chair! A chair attacking Ronda!
She delivered. There's no doubt about that. If the man wanted to send a message to Ronda Rousey, she delivered loud and clear.
The question is, will this annihilation continue Sunday at Survivor Series, led by what has become a personal, a vicious war between Ronda Rousey and Becky Lynch?
Whoa. Oh, and Santino's back in.
Finally.
Well, a fresh Santino now.
This didn't go so good last time.
No, you're right. But look at Santino. Oh, nice move.
Hip toss.
Wow.
Santino raises the roof. Thunderous headbutt.
The entire WWE Universe on their feet. Santino says, you son of a gun. Oh, nice uppercut. Or gut punch.
This could be it.
And this could do it. Off the stunner. New champ. No.
Was that a Santino stunner?
I think it was. Oh, Vladimir Kozlov. Heath Slater out on the floor.
A Santino stunner. Whoa. Hey, wait a second. Another fan has jumped into the ring.
No. Oh,
that's no fan. Certainly isn't an employee. That man is fired.
Cobra. Cobra. The Cobra.
New champions. New champions. You've got to be kidding me. John Cena has struck again.
Was Cena under the ring?
I thought it was Grimace. I just saw a giant purple thing come out from underneath the ring. That man is fired. He's got no business being here.
John Cena continues to wreak havoc on the Nexus.
At least this week, Cena didn't spill my diet soda.
Look at this.
This is just weird.
A congratulatory kiss from Tamina. And the celebration is on.
Yeah, you're right, Punk. This is weird.
What is going to happen next? Oh, he almost nailed her. Now he sees Elizabeth.
He never knew
she
was
crying.
He never knew she was here.
He doesn't believe it's her.
Everyone is standing. And I bet they're standing at home also.
Referee, I believe, just told Savage that it was indeed Sherry who was doing a number on it.
Get out of here!
Elizabeth is crying.
Elizabeth, tears flowing. What a heart on that lady.
She loved him. She's in love with the Macho King.
She's loved him from the beginning.
And I think he loves her.
Savage not sure what to do.
This is sickening.
Elizabeth with her arms outstretched. Tears flowing down.
Thank you.
trying to nail him. And Andre caught him. Two vicious chops.
Unbelievable. We're getting double our money's worth here, Gorilla.
We certainly are. And Haku with a headbutt, and he's down and out.
And the Giant stands alone in the ring.
Andre proving he can take care of himself under any circumstances. Now Heenan and Haku trying to get on the cart. Andre doesn't want him on it.
Look at this.
Andre clearing the cart of everybody.
Well, who can argue with him if he wants to ride alone?
Who's going to stop him?
That's right. And look at the ovation for Andre the Giant.
Andre leaving the sky down here to a tremendous ovation by the 65,000 plus on hand. He can do whatever he wants to do when he wants to do it. The only thing he couldn't do, Jess, was hold on to the tag team title.
Demolition, new champions, crowned here at WrestleMania 6 Sky Dome. And there you see Bobby the Brain Heenan. A little worse for wear, Gorilla.
With the brain licking his wounds, but he's still giving some verbal static.
Who's the guy that would love nothing more than to challenge you one-on-one to find out who the real king is? Got anything? Got anything? Huh? 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 I'll give it to you. I'll give it to you. Guess who? Mr.
How dare you. I'm not a common wrestler. I'm the general manager, and I'm the king. No one talks to me unless they've been granted an appointment. So I suggest you utter, I apologize.
I am Mr. Kennedy! Kennedy!
Oh! The brazen Mr. Kennedy interrupting this coronation and showing total disrespect for William Regal.
Oh!
Well, the general manager and the king is getting it handed to him by Mr. Kennedy now. He's gonna print this thing up.
Grayson Waller effect, single-handedly bringing AJ Styles to NXT.
Yeah, you can shut up now.
It's gonna take more than that, lad.
Hey, shut the hell up. This is him, the Grayson Waller. The one everyone's talking about, the biggest jackass in NXT.
And I don't know if you've seen what I do to guys like you around here, but I could end you right now if I wanted.
Do it. Do it. What, you had a good 3 weeks and you think you're a superstar? Try being phenomenal for 20 plus years. Do it. Do what you say you're gonna do.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Big Daddy Cool Diesel and Shawn Michaels victorious on the inside.
I cannot believe it.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, Shawn Michaels and Big Daddy Cool Diesel victorious here tonight on Raw.
Michaels now against Owen Hart in your house. February 18, Diesel will face the Hitman Bret Hart inside a 15-foot high steel cage as we go back now and show you, look at this from the top. Unbelievable. Watch the mistake the Bulldog makes now.
Whoa. Yeah.
Wait a minute. Let's go back. Let's go. Jim Cornette is in the ring with
Yokozuna. Owen Hart and Davey Boy are listening to the Cornette fin is spleen. He's blaming Yokozuna. He's berating Yokozuna.
And rightfully so. You said the Bulldog made the mistake. Yokozuna should have never been laying there flat on his back.
He's publicly humiliating a two-time WWF champion, a former tag team champion.
Look at Yokozuna's face. Wait a minute, Jim.
Carl, he just mashed his finger.
Hold on, Cornette.
Ready to explode.
Better back up, Cornette.
Go ahead.
Jim, look out. Believe that, McMahon. Did you see what Yokozuna? What is he doing now? Get him, boys. Get him. Get all over. Get that turncoat. Don't let him beat up Jim Cornette. Come on.
Yokozuna being pummeled, but no, he's not. Wait a minute. Yokozuna.
Get out. Get out. Get out.
Chasing Davey Boy. Chasing Owen Hart. Look at this. This behemoth has had enough. Yokozuna with a fire like we've never seen before.
You're going to sit there and watch that referee count one, two, three, and those 3 seconds will feel like 3 years because your life will flash before your eyes. Every person you stepped on to get to the top, every single life you destroyed, it's actually gonna be pretty fitting that you spend the rest of your time in the WWE cleaning toilets. And you? You better get out of the ring, because it's go time.
Oh, no. Triple H doing the math. And
oh, my! What? Are you kidding me? Luke Harper can't believe it. His former Wyatt family brethren. Eric Rowan!
I can't believe it!
Is he siding with Cena?
What the hell is he doing?
He is! Rowan!
Oh, ho, ho, ho. Look at the face! On Triple H! And did you see Stephanie?
Naya's perfectly happy just carrying my bags and walking behind me. Come on, it's Naya. She needs to be coddled because she can't handle the truth. Mm-hmm. And the truth is, I use Naya. I use her because she's a vulnerable human being. I mean, come on, look at her and look at me.
That's true. It's a big difference.
No wonder she tries to hitch her wagons onto me. But God, I can't believe she screwed us tonight, especially you.
Yeah, especially me. I mean, I can't believe it. And next week, she better.
Oh, no. Don't worry.
Yeah?
Next week when I face Asuka, Naya will be out there right where we want her. I have Naya in the palm of my hand.
Interview this evening will not be happening, but you did hear the challenge. Next week it will be Alexa Bliss versus Asuka, and I know Alexa's hoping that Naya is going to join her on this mission to put an end to. Naya, they just ran out of here. I don't know where they went. I'm gonna get out of here.
Stop! crowd really don't want to stop cheering long enough to let the man talk. He's got to feel everything that these fans are feeling for him right now. What an emotional moment.
Just in case you've forgotten, let me tell you just into who the hell I am.
I don't think they've forgotten.
I am the game. And you can bet your ass I'm back.
He's back, all right.
And you want to know why I didn't enter the Rumble last year, Hunter? I think you know. Because I was too busy pinning your ass to the mat. What do you think about that?
Well, Kurt Angle trying to steal a spotlight from a man that's had 8 months of therapy. And the game! The game! The game! Take it down, Angle! And Triple H with those big old right hands at the face of that pump of Kurt Angle!
Get out of here,
Kurt! The game now stuck with the hell of Kurt Angle! They're going to both be in the Rumble, and they're rumbling right now!
Gunther once again all by himself, looking to attack from the air.
And again, Sheamus does not allow Gunther to get to the top rope. Sheamus is now the one who's been a step ahead. And Sheamus setting up Gunther for perhaps the Celtic cross from way up high. Gunther with nowhere to go but down! Sheamus with an opportunity! Can he get to the cover? Can he make the cover? Sheamus trying to drag himself to the champion! Hooks the leg! Is this it? Sheamus is at the top! And a kick out by Gunther at 2.5! Gunther with a wicked lariat and a cover on Sheamus! And it's over! Gunther retains! Was a hell of a fight.
Yeah. Yeah.
Challenge for the title at SummerSlam? No, wait, no. Royal Rumble, that's a lot sooner. Yeah. I mean, it depends on how your elbow's feeling. I mean, how you feeling, Queenie?
No, 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 no. Rhonda, I'm challenging you tonight.
Slowly back to her feet. Spear by Charlotte. Ronda, though, turns it around. Ronda looking for the armbar.
Look at shoulders down. Charlotte got her. Charlotte got her. Charlotte got her.
Here is your winner and new SmackDown Women's Champion, Charlotte Flair.
Holy hell. Charlotte. She's now a 14-time world champion.
What the hell did we just witness, Cole?
So I'm begging you, Toronto, send me your best. I don't care if it's a civilian, if it's some former athlete that can't let go of their glory days, if it's someone that thinks they're a fighter. Send me what you got and see if they measure up. But I got a hypothesis for you. They don't. Thank you.
Who's going to answer this open challenge? I saw a pretty tough guy sweeping the hall backstage. He looked up like he'd been in a fight with life.
Oh, big surprise. There's nobody coming to answer the challenge. That's exactly what I thought.
Oh! You might want to resend that comment there, Master Gable. We got somebody, all right.
We talked about a fighter. We got one in front of him now.
A man who has been on an absolute warpath. Kevin Owens.
Canada's own KO, shouting his way to the ring. Scotiabank Arena now rocking.
With the mood Owens has been in over the last several weeks, this could be a relatively short night for Master Gable. Owens is here for one reason and one reason only, to fight.
Readopting his no-nonsense prize fighter mindset.